A very good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. I hope that all of you would have learned well about this advanced part of Writer. Writer 3 ends here. In the next class, all of you will appear for a practical test. And then Computer Shiksha will conduct a written test for all of you. Today, you will be revising some of the options that you have been taught about in the Writer 3 module. Can you tell what happens with macros? With the help of macros, you can record a message that you may be required to type repeatedly. Then, you can insert the same at any time on any of your pages. Do you know what happens with customize? With customize, you can customize the menu bar and can also customize its various options. You can also make a customized menu with your name. You can use this to create any toolbar also. Can you tell which are the characters which you cannot remove by using backspace or the delete key? These are called the non-printing characters. And when you use them, they are visible on your document but do not appear when you print your document. Can you tell what will you need to do to remove shading from the field name? When you use field name to insert date, time, author, etc. on your page, then these appear shaded and you need to use field shading to remove the shading. Can you tell what is the difference in the standard selection mode and the block area selection mode? In the case of the standard selection mode, when you select text, then it gets selected line wise only. And when you use the block area mode, then the selection is made text wise. Can you tell what happens with the use of auto text? By using auto text, you can type a text or paragraph once, and when you need to use it repeatedly in your document, then you can insert the same by using a shortcut. Can you tell how can you hide the standard toolbar? To hide it using the shortcut method, you need to click on the drop-down button appearing on the right of the standard toolbar. From the box that opens, click on the close option and the standard toolbar will get hidden. Do all of you know what happens when we use the navigator? Navigator helps you to know what all is active in your file. For example, if you have inserted some pictures and you want to know their count, then the navigator can give you that information. Similarly, you can see the tables, images, hyperlinks, sections, etc. inserted in your file and can also get their count. Let's now begin today's class. Switch on your computers and then open your Writer file. Now, type out the paragraph being shown to you. Show how will you get the same formatting done as has already been done on the paragraph given to you. If you come across a problem in doing this, then watch the video and learn. Let us watch this video and see how we can get the same formatting as was shown in the picture on the paragraph that you have typed. For getting formatting or for changing the format, you need to first select. So use any of the methods you know to select this paragraph. Then let's first change the font size. So we go to the format, we click on this down arrow and you can change it to, let's say, 18. Let's also make this bold by clicking on the bold button. And then let's also change the writing style. You have seen the writing style in the picture. Let's try and change it to the same style. Now, let's, in the picture we had seen, let's also justify this. So we are using justify. Click on the side of the paragraph to unselect it. You had seen in the picture that there were two lines, then there was a gap, then two lines. So let's do that. At the end of the two lines, in the beginning of the third line, let's press an enter. So there is a space in between. Then again, come down here, press enter so that there is space here also. So now you have three portions of two lines each. And you can do the formatting. We select the first two lines and change the font color to the color which was there in the picture. And also use the numbering option with this. Let's select the next two lines. And for this, we need to underline it and also use highlighting. So highlight the background of this text. We also have to put a bullet on the second paragraph. So let's do that first. Select once again the central two lines and select the bullet option so that the bullets get applied here. So click on the bullet button. You can see the bullets appear. Now select the last two lines. And on these two lines, we need to change the background color. So we go to this background button and select the color of our choice or that was shown in the picture. So this is how we can format on our paragraph. Now go ahead and with the help of section option, divide this paragraph into two parts. In case you have doubts, watch the video. Let us now watch this video and practice how we can divide our text paragraph into sections. So to divide the paragraph, we first need to select the entire area or the paragraph that we want to divide into sections. Take the pointer to the menu bar and click on Insert menu. And from here, look for the section option. Click there, a box appears. And by default, the section option is available, or you can select the section option. First thing you can do is you can name your sections. You can give it a name. Then you go to the columns option and you can define how many columns you want in this section. So you can say 1, 2, 3 by using the up arrow or the down arrow. Or you can also use the preview windows here. Another option here shows you whether you want to evenly distribute the content to all the columns or not. Then you have an option for width and spacing of the columns. You can define the columns, the width of the columns. You can define the spacing between the columns by using these options. Or you can also select auto width. Then the last option here is for the line, the separator line. So in between the sections, if you want to give a separator line, you can choose that. Then you can choose the height of the line. Do you want it all along the column? which is 100% or lesser or more, and then you can position whether you want it from the top or to be centered or at the bottom. So we have chosen centered. Then you can give indents, which means you can define before the section how much space you want to leave and after the section how much space you want to leave in all these columns. So you can see it in the preview window also, what kind of spacing will be left. Then go to background, and from the background you can choose the color option or graphics also. So from the color, choose the one which you like, and the buttons at the bottom you can use when you are satisfied with the color. You can choose to insert. You can also use endnote and footnote. So if you like the color, you can choose insert, or you can cancel, or you can reset to cancel out the background. If you use insert, click on that and you can see your text has been divided into two sections. There is a line in between and the background color where there was no color, which is essentially on the first part, is applied. So this is how you will use the section option. Next, insert a text frame and type something in it. Show how you can change the background color inside the text frame and also attach a hyperlink to its border. If you have a problem, watch the video. Let's watch this video now and practice the options of getting a text frame on a writer page. So to get a text frame, take your pointer to the insert menu, click there, click on frame option. A box opens and by default the type is selected. If it is not, you can select the type. Here first you can define the size, the width that you want. You can define it yourself or you can choose the automatic option. You can define the height. Again, you can choose auto size for the height also. Then the other options are for the position. Where do you want this text frame to be? Horizontally, whether you want it in the left, right, center, or at some distance from the left. Similarly, vertically, at the top, at the bottom, at the center, or at a distance from the top. And then you can choose the distance to paragraph area or left paragraph border. There are various options here that you can choose. Also, you can choose to define the anchor, anchor it to the page, to paragraph, etc. Then go to a next option, which is options. Here you can give a name for your frame. If you don't want to give a name, there is an automatic name which the computer is generating. Here it is frame 1. Then next option is wrap. So do you want the text of the page, of the writer page, to be wrapped around it? So you can choose none, or before, after, parallel, through, optimal. So any of these you can choose. You can also define the spacing for the wrap. With hyperlink, you can define a hyperlink to any file of your choice, either by browsing or directly typing the URL for a site. For instance, here we are going to type the computer shiksha site address, which is www.computershiksha.org. So this hyperlink will get applied to your text frame, and it will be easy for you to directly go to the computer shiksha website. You can name it as CS. Next option is for borders. So you can apply different types of borders. The line arrangement you can choose, whether you want borders on two sides, all four sides, etc. Then there is a line style that you can choose from, whichever style you want. You can click on that, select that. You can change the color of the line style from here, and then spacing from the contents, left spacing, right spacing. Right now we are showing you in the video how you can click on the drop down button for the color, select the color. If you don't like that selection, you can change to whatever you like. Then go to background. You can also apply shadows. Go to background and you can pick either the color or the graphics. So we can just choose the color right now and select one of the colors that we want to apply. So it will also be shown in the preview window. Then the next is columns. You can define in the text frame how many columns you want to give if you have more text. The last, of course, is for macros. So depending on this, you can just say OK, and you can see that a text frame has been applied on your writer page. You can pick it and drag it to any position on the writer page. Note that when you take your cursor or the pointer into the text frame, it shows that there is a hyperlink in this. So to open the hyperlink, it also gives you a hint that you have to press the control button with your left hand and then left click on your mouse or touchpad to open the hyperlink. By using the green dots along the text frame, you can increase the height or the width of this text frame. Again, you can position it anywhere. And then you can type any text that you want inside this text frame. For instance, we are typing computer is, and electronic machine. Any text that you want to type in the text frame, you can type here. And since you had applied a hyperlink, you can open that hyperlink directly from this text frame. So this is how you will be using the text frame on your writer page. Next, show how you will insert footnote and endnote. See the video if you need help. Let us now watch this video and once again practice the use of the footnote and endnote. We have copied some text from this page. Now take your pointer to file menu and choose a new text document. In this new text document, we are going to insert the footnote and endnote. So take the pointer to the insert menu, choose footnote and endnote option. A box opens. You have the choice of numbering and type. By default, automatic numbering and footnote is chosen as type. Let's click on OK. And you will see that you come to the end of the first page and a number 1 has been inserted as numbering. If we just paste, the text that we had copied earlier gets pasted here. This becomes our footnote. So if we click on the number 1 here in the footnote, you will see that a hand appears and you come back directly to the place where you had applied the footnote. If you click on the page, bring your cursor on number 1 which is written here and click here, it takes you to the footnote. Go to the insert menu. Once again, click on footnote, endnote. This time, let's choose character. And from this box here, we can choose any of the characters of our choice. Or we can even choose 2 characters to make 1 symbol, like we are doing here. You can scroll up and down. We've chosen 1 here. And we're choosing this And now we can click on OK. You can see that the character, the symbol has been applied. Let's choose footnote now and click on OK. You will see that the symbol comes for the end note on the last page. Now go back to one of the pages, second page of your writer, and select another piece of text and copy that using the shortcut commands and then paste here. So this becomes our end note. Now if you bring the pointer to the symbol, it appears like in hand, and when you click on it, it directly takes you to the place where the end note was applied. So if you click on the end on the symbol on the main text page, it takes you to either the footnote. If you click on footnote symbol, it takes you to the end note. If you click on the end note symbol. So how you will record a macro? Watch the video to clarify doubts that you may have. Let us watch this next video now and once again practice the use of macros. So to apply a macro, we need click on the tools menu and click on macros option. A box opens. From here, click on record macro, because first we want to record the macro. With the use of the macro, you can type a line and use it many times. Now a box appears which says record macro, stop recording. You can move this box wherever you want. And then you can type out a line or some text which you are going to be using again and again repeatedly on your writer page. So once you have recorded the macro, this text will remain in the macro and you can just get the macro and paste this text wherever you need in your writer text. Let us see how this is done. So you can type any line which you are repeatedly using. It could be your name, your address, or it could be some other text which you are repeatedly using. For instance, here we are typing the text, this class is being conducted under the aegis of computer shiksha. Once you have finished typing, then you click on stop recording. In the box for the macro, stop recording, a box opens which is for OpenOffice basic macros. Now here you can give a name for your macro, like we are giving CS_1, and you can click on, this is being saved in the standard, you can click on save. So now this has been saved. Now let's see what happens when we use the macro. So let's go and open a new writer page from file menu, click on new and click on text document so that we have a new page. Now here we want to insert the macro. Once again, we go to the tools menu, click on macros. Rather than typing the entire line again, you're just going to use the macro. Now from the options, click on organize macro, and then from the options, click on open office basic, because that is where we had saved. And you can see, you can find your macro here in the standard macros. You can see your name and click on run. As soon as you click on run, your macro, the text appears here. So this way you save time and effort on repeatedly typing the same text again and again. Now use the find option and with the help of exact match of the case, go ahead and replace some words. If you have a difficulty, see the video and learn. Let us now watch this video and practice the use of find and replace, and also see what happens when we use the match case option. Go to the edit menu, click on find and replace, the box opens, and you can type the word that you want to find. So let's type THERE. Note that we have unselected the match case here. So we have just typed THERE in small letters and we click on find. So you can say yes to this box and then close this, because the word there has been found in your writer page and it has been highlighted. You can close this box and you can see that the word THERE, although it has a capital T, has been found because we did not ask it to match the case. Once again, go to edit, go to find and replace. When the box opens, now we are clicking on match case. So we want it to match the case for the word that we type exactly. Now when we type THERE in small, it says it cannot find that word. So click on OK. Next, change this word and type it with T capital, THERE. Match case is already selected. Now if you click on find, it will be able to find because the case is matching. The word has been written exactly as it is on your in your writer page. So this way you can find the word when the match case. Now you can also see how you can replace it. You can type the word here, click on replace, click on OK here, and you can see that your word THERE there has been replaced by the word HERE here. So this is how you will use the find and replace option. And next, show how will you format this entire paragraph text wise. If you have a difficulty, see the video and learn. Watch this video now to practice the use of text wise formatting. So for doing that, let's select some words from our writer page. So we've selected one word here. Let's go to the format menu bar and change the font size. Let's select the next couple of words. And for this, let's underline them. We're just practicing formatting. Choose the next two words of the line. And let's change the format here by changing the color of the font. Next couple of words we select, let's change the font size, font style. So we can pick on one of the font styles that we like, click on that, select the next few words or the next line. Once again, let's change the font style here also, get a different style. Few more words or one more line we are selecting and changing the highlighting color, giving it some highlighting color. So we select from here whatever color we like to highlight. So this is how you will be using the format menu bar for formatting your text. Today's class ends here, so go ahead and save and then close your file and then properly shut down your computers. In today's class, you practice some of the options that you have learned in this module of Writer 3. In the next class, you all will appear for a practical test. After that, Computer Shiksha will conduct a written test for you. Computer Shiksha is supported by, thank you.